The Control Surface Editor can be used to place specific controls from your preset in the performance area so that you can use them for expression during your performance. Tapping on the green plus icon will bring up a browser that will allow you to find every controller on every effect in your preset. You can select the controller that you are interested in, and you can choose what type of UI element will be displayed in the performance area. Controls can also be deleted by tapping the red X, and can be reordered with a long press and a drag. Multiple controllers can be assigned to the same control. In this case, the phaser, flanger, and tremolo depths, as well as the guitar string stiffness, are assigned to the same slider. The vertical Y motion of a key can be used for expression. In this case, the volume control on the volume pedal is assigned to key Y. Independent controllers can be assigned to the X and Y axes of the expression pad. In this case, stiffness is assigned to the Y axis and vibrato depth is assigned to the X axis. Controllers that are assigned to controls can be modified by a lookup table known as a curve. This creates many new sonic opportunities. Here is an example that makes extensive use of key Y curves. This preset has four controllers assigned to key Y. Here is the curve for harmonic number. Notice that the crosshair shows the current position in the lookup table as a function of the expression control. Here is the curve for pick position. Here is the curve for the distortion level. Here is the curve for the volume pedal level. Key step curves make it possible to change the value of a controller each time a new note is played. In this case, the arpeggiator is running, and the key step curves are creating a variety of different values for a number of controllers. Let's look at the key step curves for each controller. Here is the step curve for material. Here is the step curve for chorus delay. Here is the step curve for tuning. With a key number curve, you can set the value of a controller as a function of the key number that is being played. Here is an example where the string is stiffer for higher key numbers. The crosshair indicates the current key number that is being played. Next, the setlist editor.